who you are. I am Sri Watson. I'm an engineer on the Lightning Reports team. And today we will be going through a small demo as well as a presentation about how to build powerful and performant reports and dashboards. Forward-looking statement. This presentation contains forward-looking statements about trend analysis and future events and other things which might be available in future. Please don't base your purchasing decisions on the things which you see here. A huge shout out and thank you to all our customers, stakeholders, as well as all trailblazers. Without you, wherever you are, all of these things around Salesforce will not be possible at all. And a huge thank you from our team and from the company as well for continued support as well as all the products which we use. A little bit about what's on the agenda for today. So regarding performant reports and dashboards, what we'll be going through is around the report types and something about the Unified Analytics Home, which is a brand new feature which we are introducing, as well as the basic bread and butter of reports, the report creation part, what all the enhancements we have done there, as well as some things about report run. And in dashboards, we have some cool new exciting features coming about text widget, image widget, and then where all you can use reports around in Slack as well as subscriptions. So let's straight away jump on to the demo. As you can see here, let's start off with the report types. I think a lot of people who are users of reports and dashboards have been creating reports out of the report types. So one of the main things with report types is the standard report types as well as custom report types. The exact thing around standard report types is standard report types mimics whatever the objects of Salesforce are. For example, let's say you have an opportunities or an accounts. We have standard report types for everything right here, like opportunities or accounts or any standard Salesforce object you take. We have a standard report type. You don't have to worry about creating a report type for that. However, the bulk of the users for us want to create, hey, what do I do with an account, an opportunity with accounts, an opportunity with whatever object I create? How do we do that? The best way to do it is around creating a custom report type. Where do I create a custom report type? A custom report type can be created from our setup. A setup right here is in the custom report type. You can create a new custom report type right here. And let's say I want to create an opportunities with accounts. And I create the primary object as an opportunity. And let me give a label right here. And a pretty good description of that as well. Now, while doing this, you can actually store it in one of the categories where you want to see it. Let's say I created this and then, you know, I'm going inside to actually set this custom report type up. So our primary object right here is going to be an opportunities object. And what I'm going to add here is a left outer join relationship with, let's say, other collaborators, like, let's say, others. And if you want, I can add up to three objects right here, as you can see. And let's say we have just opportunities with orders around here. And then once I go and save it, your custom report type is actually created right here. And one of the main things which you can do in this custom report type is you can go and edit the layout and, you know, configure the lookups as well. For example, right here, let me go and edit a layout here. So as you can see, you have all the opportunities right here, all the fields and opportunities, as well as all the fields and orders. Let's say I want to add some related fields via lookup. How do I do that? So as you can see here in the opportunities fields, there's a new button here to add a related field via lookup. If you click on here, I want to go inside account name as we just saw in the creating custom report type. Let me click on account name and let's say I want just the account ID to be added here. And voila, there you go. You get the account ID as a lookup from opportunities. So you can have an account with opportunities with account right here. You go ahead and save it. And you have created an opportunities with accounts custom report type right here. And where I can actually see this is in a report type creator. So let me go back from where we started. So once you go into the reports tab, you can see a new reports it'll have all the standard report types which we already created, as well as the ones which we created right now, which is opportunity with account. That's, there we go. And creating a new opportunities with accounts will have all the objects which we added right there, as well as the new objects which we added through lookup, the account name and the account ID. So this is actually seen in the filter. Well, I mean, based on the filters, whatever we have, we can see the data right here as well. Now, this is part of the standard report type as well as custom report type. So there is some other thing which we have added to actually make creating a report much more easier. So we have added something called the enhanced report type selector. So what this enhanced report type selector is now, so earlier we just used to list down the standard report types here. And with this enhanced report type selector, if you click on the opportunities, you can see all the details about opportunities right here. For example, what are the fields in opportunities? What are the reports which are being used within opportunities? So you can see all the fields inside opportunities, as well as some of the reports created by opportunities and created by others as well, as well as what are the objects used in each report type. So if you don't want your admin if you don't want your users not to use this report type, you can go ahead and hide this report type as well. So these are some of the things which have added as part of enhanced report type selector. One more important thing around this enhanced report type selector is that if you have a custom report type, like the one which we just created, you can go ahead and see the objects which is being used as well. So as you saw during our custom report type, we created an opportunity with an inner join to order. You can see the actual two objects and the join as well right here as part of the enhanced report type selector. So what do I do now once I create the report? What are the other enhancements which we have created? So let me open an existing report here with hop history. So one feature which was more asked for us was that, hey, let's say one of my users want to self-reference his own name. For example, let me go to edit. I'm an admin who creates reports and I want my user to see only their data. So what we have added here is part of the reporting type is that for opportunity name or owner, you can go ahead and use a relative value. For example, this dollar user. Dollar user is a pretty used value across Salesforce where it references to the current user. So if I go and apply this filter, what it does basically is that it shows it actually filters by the current user, whoever is logged in. So this is a pretty interesting functionality. If you want to, you know, go ahead and remove it, just use this custom value, whatever you want, or just go ahead and delete this. So self-referencing a user is a new filter which we have added as well. Cool. So now we have seen about how you create a report, what the enhanced report type selector is, as well as what the reference current user in the report. There is one thing which is going GA in this release, which is basically the Unified Analytics Home. What is the Unified Analytics Home? As you've seen across Salesforce, we have multiple analytics assets around reports, dashboards, as well as a lot of things around CRM, maybe CRM analytics and Analytics Studio as well. We have now a place where all of these things can be seen in one place, which is the Unified Analytics Home. How do you get there? Just click on the Analytics tab, which you see here, and all you can see is a unified home for all the analytics assets. As you can see here, this is the Unified Analytics Home. And if you go inside browse, you have an app, all the apps which are there in your org, all the dashboards, which is basically Lightning dashboard as well as CRMA dashboards, all the reports, which is listed here, all the lenses as well as all folders. This is something which is pretty new and which eases the life of admins as well as all the users to see all your assets in one single place. One other enhancement which we have added for this is the collections. So what is a collection? We know the concept of folders, but we don't know the concept of a collection. So as everybody knows, a report folder is something which contains a folder of all the reports, whatever reports which an admin curates and keeps in the folder. However, a collection is something where you can have multiple analytics assets, not just reports. It can be across all assets. Let's go to one of those collections. So as you can see here, this is a combination of a CRMA dashboard, a lightning dashboard as well. Let me go ahead and create a collection. In this collection, what I want to have is a mix of both reports as well as dashboards. So I can go inside and select any of the, yes, I can go inside and add some of the assets which I wanted to add right here. Let it be a report, let it be a dashboard, any items you can add in here. And as always, you can share it to widely around users. Whatever the same sharing rules for Salesforce applies, it applies here as well. This is something which was very much asked feature by our customers, to have a single place of sharing across all assets. So that is something which is very, very, very usage specific. The other enhancement which probably would make a lot of sense around here is the inline editing. So let's say I have earlier, when we had reports and dashboards, most of the edit part, it was mostly read only for reports. However, if you want to edit, you want to go to the actual record page or list views to edit it. We have now introduced the ability to edit within the reports itself. As you can see here, we have a new enable field editing button here, which once enabled, you can edit all the fields and reports right here. For example, this is an opportunity report and our opportunity name. I'm just gonna go and edit it. And the best part about this, you can do a multi-edit as well. So I just edited one thing, it just shows what was changed. And once you go here, you can edit up to 200 values. And then, you know, once you give save, it's gonna save every edit at the same single time, and you're gonna see the new values right here. So you don't have to go anywhere and other than reports to see your data, to update your data and manipulate your data and save your data as well. It's all in one place. This is around reports, all the enhancements around reports. Now let's talk a bit about dashboards as well. As you know, dashboards has been the place where you view and edit reports. So you can go to dashboards right from here, and let's say I want to add this report to a dashboard. You can just click on add to dashboard right here. It takes us to the dashboard tab where we can create a dashboard. Let's say I want to create a new dashboard. And I'm going to add it to this. As you can see here, this chart is going to get added. However, this is something which we already have. What's new about this? But we have added some brand new widgets to the dashboard. For example, if you look at here, we have a new chart, or we have a new text or image widget. The chart or table widget has been there for a long time, which is where we view the report. However, the text widget, you can have here. You can have a rich text, as well as you can add indentation. Let me add a bit of a color, as well as you can have it as an link, and you can add it right here. That gives an extra flavor to your dashboard, where you can have multiple things around the reports and have multiple headings as well. This is one widget which was added. The other interesting widget is the image widget. Let's say images tell a story and like nothing else. So let's say I want to add a new image to that, and you can upload many types of images, like an SVG, a PNG, JPEG, GIF, anything. And there you go. So there are multiple parameters which you can choose to actually, you know, position your image well so that it looks good. And you can have a tooltip as well as an alternate text right here. So as you can see, you're able to view a GIF right here. And there you go. The dashboard looks great. And now you have a report as well as an image as well as a text widget, all within the same dashboard as well. The other thing which also wanted to show everyone was that now we can, the reports can be, reports and dashboard can be viewed on Slack as well, where all the details of this is shown in Slack. And there is also a new feature coming where you can post from reports and dashboards into Slack. That's coming in the next few releases. So that's going to happen so that you can have reports accessible everywhere as well. The other thing which everyone knows about reporting subscriptions and notifications as well. That is something which is going to be important in Slack. For example, let's say I'm going to subscribe to this report. You should be able to send it to Slack from this as well. But however, more than that, there was a huge need across the Salesforce community to have subscriptions, reporting on subscriptions, right? How many of my users actually have subscriptions and how many of my users want to report on that? This is a new cool feature which we just added where you can report on a subscription as such. How do you report on a subscription? Well, we already have a tool to actually add a custom report type, right? We use the same thing to report on subscriptions as well. So go to your custom report type and create a new custom report type. And the important thing here is the basic object which we are going to use is the analytic notification. And let's create another report type to see all the subscriptions. This should give us a lot of insights into how many subscriptions are being used, how many notifications are being used across the org, as well as a good thing about all the subscriptions which are being actually used by the user and where all the source of the subscription is. So as you can see, you've added the analytics notification. We can either leave it this way or you can add it to the threshold as well. Let's say I'm going to save this. There we go, report with subscription. Now, let's go ahead and report on this. You create a new report. And where did we save it? We saved it right here. Now let's start a report and add a column. What is the report name which is being used? What is the source? There we go. And was it created? So as you can see, we just created a Lightning Report subscription and you can just go ahead and report on it. So there is one report which has a Lightning Report subscription which was created on so-and-so date. This in, as such is a very, very great enhancement, as in you know about all the subscriptions and notifications which are being created across the org, as well as now that the number of notification subscriptions has also increased and the sources where it comes from, for example, email, chatter, or even Slack, this will be a good measure of where all the subscriptions are and who all have subscribed to the reports and dashboards. So these are all the enhancements with reports and dashboards. And the reason why we branded as being Performant Reports and Dashboards is that all of these enhancements have been done keeping in mind the performance of reports and just to make sure any report or dashboard is fast enough to actually do proper operations as well as get the data pretty much at a very good rate as well. So thank you for joining, and I hope this was very useful in creating and reporting on Salesforce data using reports and dashboards. Thank you.
Thank you for watching. We would love to get your opinion on this content, so please leave us some feedback on the comment section below. If you did like this content, give that like button a tap. And of course, if you want to see more videos like this, subscribe to the Salesforce Admins YouTube channel. If you want to learn more about being a Salesforce admin in general, head on over to admin.salesforce.com. Thanks again.